Welcome to new Savage OS Dev podcast, development podcast. And last time I implemented the multi-select bar for FileCat and I found some issues with the remove function. First of all, you can see it's a void. Remove dir and remove. It's two separate functions here for removing files or folders. Files and folders. So as remove dir will do, it removes the files inside of a folder and then the folder itself if it's necessary or if it is able to do this. And this is a problem I had last time because it's a void here, and you can see if I go to remove cursively, it will give back a bool. So true for it worked and false for it didn't, and the same goes for also the remove function on qfile. You can see it's a bool and it will give me a true if it's successful, otherwise return a false, and if it's false I have to then notify the user somehow, because yeah, what FileCat does is if remove does not work, it just simply does not remove and does not inform the user about this. So this needs to be changed, obviously. And this is one thing that I want to do right now. The other problem is, as it is remove recursively, and it is a function that, yeah, well, could take its time. The remove function, I doubt, because usually Linux file systems are fast enough, even on smartphones nowadays. But if you want to remove recursively something and it's gigabytes of files on your device, it can block the UI. So what we need to do is have this function running in the background. And yeah, it's the same problem that I solved already, luckily, in my cp file or copy file function, which connects to a watcher and which runs the process concurrently with qconcurrent. As you can see here, it's running the cp file process in the background, basically, and it just waits until it's finished, and then it will send a signal, and the watcher is therefore for catching the signal. And if the finished signal is received, it will then jump to the cp finished function and will emit a cp result changed, among other stuff. And this is basically what I want now to do also with the remove functions. So what I decided on is I have already a watcher here, which is using a bool. So for the copy process, so I'll just reuse it also for my remove process. And of course, what I also decided to do is, because what I have two functions, remove dir and remove, and I have let's go to the QML file, open dialog, I think we can see it. No, it's in multi-select bar. You can see it. Where is it? I have an if here. If it is a file, the current path that I want to delete, then call the remove function, otherwise call the remove dir function. Why should I have this in my QML code if I could just simply have one remove function that will simply remove the file or the directory regarding if it is a file or a directory? So move this out of a QML, move it into C++ to gain a little bit of speed and a cleaner code maybe. And also we have the same with the copy file stuff as well. So that's the first thing that I want to do. So what I'm going to do is I will have a remove function that will basically look like the copy file function, and yeah, it will simply do nothing else than connect to a watcher, to the watcher here, wait for the finished signal, and then execute the finished method. And yeah, let's just, instead of talking, let's just do it. So what I will do right now is just simply copy this and paste it in here. And what I will do is just rename this rm so the function will be called rm, and I think it should be a bool for it to work. Yes, so what I will do is have a bool out of rm and will return this value, as it will return a bool anyway. So this is the rm function. Then the remove function itself will be looking a bit different. Why is this qdebug stuff still in here? What we will do is simply call the rm function or the remove tf function, depending if the file is a the string is a directory, or if the URL here is a directory or a file. So what I will do is just simply is file. So if this is file. So basically what I'm doing is, let's go to here, is using this here, this if. I will put it in the C++ FM helper. If this is file, then this rm and then the URL, else it will remove dir URL. So this is the first thing that we have right now. Then the remove dir will be a bool as well, and we will return this value. So now we have this, and what we will do, what we can do right now in the Moody select bar is just simply, we don't need this if, we just call the fm remove. We can get rid of the if, and not only this here, but also in file item delegate, we also have a remove here if file is dir, and then do all the stuff for when it's a dir or not. And what we will do is here simply remove this and have this a bit smaller and cleaner. So we'll remove now, deleting, and then fm remove. And we don't need to check if it's a dir or not, because we have this code now in C++. So now let's go back to C++ code and take a look at how to... First of all, is this correct? Of course, it's missing the URL. Okay. And so sometimes it makes sense to take a look while there's a red underlying indicator for a function. In this case, I missed the URL. Something obvious, of course. So what we have to do now is just simply copy this. I will just copy the copy stuff here. the copy file method. And yeah, okay, this is what we want to do. This is a bool for whatever reason. It does not need to be a bool, it can be a void as well. So just like my remove function here is a void. Okay, we have to... This is interesting. I think we have to do it differently, maybe. Because we have a 1Q future and it's calling one and connecting to one thing. So what I think I will do is have... have a function have a bool here which is called rm, and have this called remove file instead. It will return the remove file, and this one will do this makes things easier, I think. So we have an rm function, that will have the if statement, and it will return this remove file then URL, otherwise it will return the remove dir. So we have one remove function that we will call from public, and we have private slots. These should be private. So the remove file and rm function are stuff for the private slots, so we put them here in the private slots so no one can call them outside. And the same goes for remove dir, because it's not public anymore, but private. So let's do this. So we have remove function, it will connect to the watcher, it will wait for the finished signal, and then it will call cp finish, which is not correct. It should call rm finished, which is a new function that I will create in a second. And the git concurrent run should not happen on cp file, but it should happen on rm. On the rm function. And why do we have here two? We only need one. One argument, which will be the URL, of course. And this does not need to have any URL. The rm finished signal. And yeah, watch us at the future. Okay. This looks okay-ish to me. So what we will do now, I think most of the people understood now. So what I did is we have an rm function, which is a private function, which will check if this is a file, and then we will call the remove file function, which will remove a file and return something. It's a bool. And if it's not a file, it will call the remove dir function, which is also a bool, which will return also a bool, and then we get a bool back from the rm function. And this is the one that we are then looking at when running the rm function here. And yeah, the remove is the one that is in public slot that we have then calling from the QML side, just like here, the remove. Yeah, what we need is the rm function. Do we have, we don't have this rm function. The rm finished function, we will just simply copy the cp finished. It's a simple void, put it here, and we call it rm finished. Oops, rm finished. We don't need a string for this, we don't have any parameter. We wanna have an MRM result in this case, and so wait for the result. And the MRM result is the one that we will also put in our debug output. And if it is true, why do we check it here right now? We don't need to check it here right now. This is for the copy stuff, and we will just emit a signal as well so that we can react on stuff which is not CP result changed but RM result changed. And yeah, we now have to create this RM result, which is a private function. This is why it's called M in front of it. So we have here CP result, and we'll do the same with bool M rm result. And then we need to have a signal, which will be void rm result changed. And let's take a look, what are we missing? Rm result changed, this means we should have an public CP result, which is giving back the CP result, and we need the same for the RM result. So we have an RM result, and it of course should give back the MRM result entry. So this should now work just fine. What the only thing, I think this the C++ side should be okay now. We don't need this comment here. We have Qdebug output just for fancy things to see if the stuff works out or not. And what we will do is now we have to take a look at the QML side of things. We have a connection here to FM already, and we are listening to on source changed, on CP result changed, and do certain things, just like showing file operation succeeded or error. And basically what I will do is just copy the same stuff here in QML, and because we are now listening for RM result changed, notice that because we have a signal here called didn't want to close anything. Let's take a look here. We have a signal called RM result changed, and to access it on the QML side, it's called on RM result changed. But it's you have to see just know that it has camel case, so the R in this case needs to be big R. So what we are checking right now is then the RM result. If it's not okay, then error removing, or I think the terminology was here, deleting file. And deleting, what I will just deleting, maybe I will make it easier like this so I don't need to error deleting files. I can print a message as well, which will be this is the message, sorry, and then have an info banner telling about this problem. And of course, if this worked out, what I could do here instead of this is just simply remove the watcher. No, I don't remove the watcher here. If it worked out, I can say file operation succeeded. But I'm thinking now about this could be a problem because of multiple file removals. It will then print multiple times that it has the file operation succeeded. But the same happens also on pasting multiple files, so doesn't matter. I think I didn't notice it so far, so it should be no problem. File operation succeeded, or instead of file operation succeeded, I could say deletion succeeded or something. File deletion succeeded. File deletion succeeded. And yeah, show this, and then the buzzer indicator should not be running anymore. This means, in other words, if I remove something within my file item delegate, the remove function itself should have buzzer indicator running too. And the same goes for the multi-select bar. Not only removing this, but also have this set to true. And it will then, if the remove is successful, the buzzer indicator will stop spinning. The buzzer indicator is the one in the top left here that will keep spinning and spinning and spinning if you copy large files, or if you remove large files and it will take a while, or if you open up simple text documents or something like this. So let's close this. Let's hope that I didn't do any very stupid mistake, and let's compile the code again and let's see if it will then work out. What I will do again is create some documents here to remove, some files to remove, And of course, these are all 0 byte files, but maybe we will see a spinning spinner on the top left corner. Compiling takes a little bit, but then we are. Some people were asking why compiling takes so long. I don't know. I'm guessing that it's not using all the cores in the virtual machine where it's compiling the stuff. I think it has by default only one core that it uses. Good. Open up VirtualBox and then set up the amount of CPUs higher in the virtual machine. See something we can see. Okay, this apparently its configuration has 4 CPU cores and 3 GB of RAM, which I set up, but the emulator is not compiling the code, so I have to maybe set the emulator stuff, the SDK, the stuff a little bit higher, which is I can show you this later on. So first of all, let's check if this will work. So let's mark the files here. What's going on? Oh, no. Let's mark all the files for deletion and let's see if it will work. So this is fine so far. And it's giving me error deleting files. And I don't see anything on home Nemo, which means this is super, super bad. Okay, files are still there. For a second, I really thought, shit, it removed my home directory from my SDK. Let's open it again. Oh, it said error deleting files, but you can see it deleted the files. Ah, interesting. So let's see what the output says. So, deleting test with name test. Okay, deleting doc1 with. Yeah, that's true. Then this. Aha, it's giving me CP result. Doesn't matter. Did not rename it correctly. You can see it here. Is it C++ stuff? Here in the output, I forgot to rename it RM result. But it's giving me true, 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 and true. And on RM results changed, error is giving me error deleting files for whatever reason. But it is set to true here. Let's check what did I miss in my open dialog. RM result. I'm checking for RM result, and if this is false, it will give me error deleting files. If it's true, it will say it will say file deletion successful. Is this really? Is this really? Let's see. Yeah, it's called RM result. Return RM result. And yeah, it's watching for the result and will emit the change. Oh. And so it's doing the right thing for. So it's removing the right files. It's showing me an error message for whatever reason. And it's clearing my. This is weird. This is really, really weird. Let's do this again. So we have now all the stuff here. And let's see what it does. So now it does not remove all the things, so it will maybe a hiccup. But it's telling me error removing files. But the signal here is set to true. Which doesn't make any sense. MCP result. Let's take a look what FMCP result is. It's a bool. RM result, CP result. Is this updated? Yes, it is. That's weird. Console log, let's check what the result is. RM result. Result, yeah. Let's compile this again and let's do this. By the way, I can show you, I think, the compile thingy. Where do I have it? Yeah, I have the VirtualBox and there I have the build engine. And the build engine is using like nothing in terms of processor and RAM. So this is the reason why it's so slow in building stuff. Yeah. I will change this later when I stop the build engine. So wait a second, I have to close the first one so I don't have any confusion. Let's do this again with all the files here. Let's select and remove them. This is nicely working so far. The only thing is that it's telling me error deleting files. Another question is why. Now there we have the problem. The RM result is undefined. This is why we get error deleting files. Because the RM result is undefined. Why is it undefined? CP result, RM result, MRM result. This is a pool. This is this one here. Yeah. And we're only changing it here. Why is it set to undefined? Let's take a look for CP result. Where does this appear? Yeah, we are also setting it here. There we have the problem. We are missing EQ property binding stuff, of course. So this is basically for QML stuff to read stuff. So here we have a RM result or bool RM result that we have to set here for QML to access it, and of course a notification that that will be sent when the RM result changes. So this is what we forgot to do. If I fix this right now and rerun the stuff, you will see that this will work. Let's do this again here with all our test files, and then we should have a working better solution for removing files, which will work without blocking the UI when removing large big files or when removing large big folders with lots and lots of little files inside. So it will not block, and it will in the end, when removing is done, it will give you a notification of some sorts that says deletion completed. So now we've all the files. Let's remove them. Wait for 5 seconds. And file deletion succeeded. As you can see, it's working fine. So, yeah. That's everything for this little video. You can see it wasn't so hard to do it, especially if you did it already once for the CP stuff. Now we have a nice error message if file deletion does not work. Let's just for the sake of it test it. How did I do it last time? Create a test folder here and then touch some stuff inside, like doc123.txt, and yeah, now we have these files here, and now deletion does not work. Let's use the normal delete function in this case because it's only one folder. It should not work and give you an error message. Yeah, error deleting files, as you can see. So this is working fine because it does. It's not giving you the reason why it is a problem. Let's see. I don't think with the way that I implemented it right now with rmdir, remove dir, what it's doing right now. It's only giving you a false or a true. It's true if it works out and a false if it doesn't work out. It's not giving you the reason why it didn't work out. So, yeah. I'm not sure if there any remove function for directories which would give you the option to... we have an rmdir function. Remove the directory specifically with your name. The directory must be empty, true or false. The rm path. Remove the directory path, dir path. The function will remove all parent directories in dir path provides that they are empty. This is an opposite of mcar path. Aha. Also true or false. So there's no error that I get why it's not working. So I cannot get into more details there, but at least we have a nice output, error output for RM if RM is not working fine or correctly. Yeah, and I think this is everything for this little video demonstration. And one thing I can show you, I will show you in the next video, is how to improve the compile times for your Selfish S stuff. Thanks for watching, subscribe, like.